water from the rock, and the grumbling children followed like a misbegotten flock. He climbed upon a mountain they couldn't even touch. Who'd have known that one encounter could have ever meant so much? And up upon that high place, in a cleft of solid stone, his face was set on fire as the God of glory shone. He alone had seen it and had lived to tell the tale, but because they feared the fire, he had to hide behind a veil. A face that shone with the radiance of the Father, though it had known and endured dark desert days. A face that shone with the glory of another, soon the prophet would discover as the glory was fading away. He was the bread from heaven, he would be the smitten rock. He had 12 confused disciples, they were his bewildered flock. When he climbed upon the mountain, he took Peter, James, and John. In the face of pending glory, they soon began to yawn. As he prayed while they were sleeping, he was transfigured into light. His face a flash of lightning, his clothes so burning bright. So Moses finally saw the face before he'd hidden from. Then came a voice from heaven, "This is my beloved Son." The face that shone is the glory of the Father, and he had known from the start that it was so. The face that shone had let the light shine out of darkness, and we're changed into his likeness as we gaze upon the sun. But you and me, we tend to flee from shining faces. We see the glow and then we know that we're undone. They shine his light into our emptiest of spaces, and with their bright and shining faces reflect the radiance of the sun. The face that shone is the glory of the Father, and he had known from the start that it was so. The face that shone had let the light shine out of darkness, and we're changed into his likeness as we gaze upon the sun.